A little girl came up to me. She knew me. She was about 8 years old and had beautiful blonde hair. I knew she had died of cancer, and I think she was some kind of ambassador in heaven, because all she did was go from group to group and sing glorious songs. Brother Richard, do you want to see what I can do? She promptly proceeded to mess up her beautiful hair, hair that she had lost when she suffered cancer. When she stopped, it immediately returned to perfection. There are no bad hair days in heaven. And her hair was now beautiful. Brother Richard, would you like to hear me sing? She started singing, the most beautiful, powerful soprano voice you could imagine. Heaven's ambassador was singing, and the choirs of heaven joined in. This was the most beautiful song I had ever heard. And she was only 8. But she was not the only child I saw. There were many other children, and each had abilities far greater than any adult on earth. No child is ever lost. Jesus has every one of them, and they are with him, and they enjoy his presence. Many times I saw the Lord take little children and hug them and draw them to himself and talk with them. It seemed so refreshing to him that the little children were with him. In one place, I saw a young boy sitting before a piano that must have been 100 feet in every direction. It looked like a baby grand piano, yet in the middle of it, there stood an upright harp. No one was playing it, but this young boy was sitting there, and it was in an open place, like a courtyard by some homes. As he sat there, he played the most beautiful music, and people joined in. While this child was playing the piano, the angels were standing at attention, some with their arms raised, worshiping God. This little child was playing this song with notes that were reverberating throughout all of heaven. Choirs were joining in. It was unbelievable and glorious. And this little child was doing all of this. I asked, "How can this be?" One of the angels spoke to me and said, "They are playing this song because you are here. They want you to know that in heaven, even a child can learn things that are impossible to learn while on earth." I was told, "Look at the little child." I noticed that he wasn't over 7 or 8 years old. He turned to me, smiled, and waved his right hand and continued playing with his left. Then he stopped. The piano stopped. The harp stopped. The people stopped. Everyone started to smile and praise the Lord. The song was over, but I could somehow hear it echoing. The boy said, "I can play anything I want to." And everyone was happy about it. I saw lots of children in heaven. Some looked like they had died during birth or shortly after. But in heaven, they had total powers of speech, and they were completely sentient. They knew and understood what you were saying to them and could talk back. Most amazing thing to see. I saw a number of children like this. They were being carried by angels and other people. There was a nursery in heaven where I saw hundreds, maybe millions of children of that age. They were tended to by angels and people who came by, and relatives too. They grew up at a tremendous rate. They were not babies very long. Then I saw children that were old enough to walk and run and play, and they did just like they would play on earth. I saw one of the games they played. They formed a circle. There may be just a few or a lot of children in the circle. They picked someone, and he would float in the air in the middle of the circle. Someone would give him a little shove, and he would begin to float back and forth across the circle. They all giggled with great glee. The child floating through the air would giggle and giggle. It was a wonderful experience for them. It would be a great experience for me. Another game was to see how far they could jump. Children would jump 100 or 200 feet in the air and float down like a butterfly. An amazing sight. Then I saw, as they grew older, they began to attend school, just like here on earth. But the schools were amazing. Children would learn things that geniuses here would not know or understand. I saw the Lord himself come and take many children and hug them and squeeze them and tell them cute little stories. They loved him, and he loved them so very much. I could not tell by looking at them if they had ever been sick. I am sure some had died here on earth and went to heaven, but when there, they were 100% absolutely healthy, with rosy little cheeks, cherub-like. And they could run and play. In one place I saw them having foot races. They would run faster than a horse could run. It was amazing. Another place I saw them actually riding on some horses I saw in heaven. The horses loved it, and they loved the children. It was a wonderful experience. I saw a child about 5 years old sitting at an easel, painting. He would tell the paintbrush the color or colors he wanted, and the paintbrush would turn to that color. I saw him painting a picture of the countryside, and he would say, "No, darker. The tree must be darker." The paintbrush would turn that color, and he would just wipe across the canvas one time, and the tree would appear. In heaven, all things are possible. All of the children were very happy. For all the children, their hair was perfect, their clothing was perfect. Some had little play suits on, some had robes, others didn't. All the children were very friendly and very loving. Just before I was taken to the throne, I saw one avenue just off the street I was walking on. It was a huge avenue that branched off a little bit to the right and joined with another main street that went down heaven. The avenue was 20 to 30 miles long, and I could plainly see the other side. The avenue was about 250 feet wide, and people were walking up and down the beautiful golden and crystal streets that were made of diamonds, or maybe just one big diamond of some kind. You could see through this diamond, and it had layers of gold and silver, and there were precious stones everywhere. There were mansions on this street beyond compare. I was told they were for missionaries. Everything they gave to the Lord. I believe that in heaven, God rewards everything that we can't receive here. Some had just recently died, and there were large groups of people welcoming them at the veil. I saw one coming, and he was dressed in a beautiful robe. One of the first things he did was grab his clothes and say, "Oh, how beautiful! I am not in rags anymore." His robe was spun gold, and there were thousands of people meeting him. The rewards of missionaries are great, and God loves missionary-minded people. I was taken to one house on the street I was walking. It was a single house carved out of a single giant pearl. It was 250 to 300 feet across and 100 feet tall. It was a mansion carved out of a pearl. The furniture in it was formed by angels who molded and carved the pearl into shape. Even the chandelier was carved out of the pearl, and it was lit. It glowed from within. The house made of pearl belonged to a woman, and the angels told me her story. Her name was Pearl, and she was a missionary. She was known for her giving to the poor. Eventually, she died of starvation. The House of Pearl was a reward for a pure heart. There were many other houses on this street, many different kinds, and they were unbelievable to even consider building any place but in heaven. One street corner I was going by, whether walking or floating, I do not know, an angel was holding me by the arm. I wanted to stop and see a specific mansion. We stopped for a moment. It appeared to be made of solid gold, but there was wood there too. There were hundreds of people in this mansion. All were people that this one missionary had led to the Lord. He had been a part of their family's lives. Now they were still a part of his big family, and they were really joyous. It was unbelievable, the peace and tranquility that was there. I saw houses that were brightly lit from the inside, and the architecture was beautiful. In heaven, it seems that the architecture of the day has pillars, large pillars. Every home had large porches with pillars in front of them and huge archways. Some of the homes were made out of what seemed to be a brick or stone type of material. Some were made out of a wood type material. Yet, as I looked, there were no nails or even pegs. Not a piece was sawn, but everything was crafted somehow and fit perfectly together. The fit was so perfect, no nails were needed. It was as if the house had formed itself into existence. I saw a veranda in one home that looked like onyx stone. You could see through it. It was clear as glass. Inlaid in the porch were precious stones and gold and silver, the things we hold so dear. And there were great diamonds. Everything is so beautiful, but they all dim at the very look of Jesus. When you see Him, even the beautiful architecture of heaven dims to look on His wonderful face. Just one glimpse of Him, and everything dims in comparison. He is the expressed image of the Father, and all of heaven revolves around the Lord and His great mercy. I saw several large cities in heaven, and in each city were large streets. One particular area I was going to, I knew had seven main streets that ran towards the throne. They were huge streets, but the architecture was indescribable. I saw a home made of clear stone with roses that were alive and growing and yet were embedded in the stones, and they gave off the most beautiful aroma. You could put your ear up to anything solid in heaven, and you could hear it humming the most beautiful songs. Some of the songs we have here, some we don't. Everything gives praise and glory to the Lord. The angels told me I had to stop here. Somebody wants to talk to you. I walked up to the door, and it was my grandfather's house. He was sitting on the front porch, and Grandma was there too. I remember falling down on my knees and saying, "Grandpa." He stood up, and it was as though he was 28 or 30 years old. When he died, he was 97. Now, he was in perfect health, and so was Grandma. We hugged, and I just didn't know what to say. After a few moments, they said, "Richard, you have an appointment with God. But you will be back. Your home is just over yonder." And they pointed down the street, and there was an open place for a home to be built. I have never thought I have done anything to deserve all the goodness God has shown me, especially this. Suddenly, I was gone from them. I knew they were smiling. They knew what was going on. They had been told. I also saw William Branham. He was sitting by himself, talking with the Lord. I didn't want to interrupt him. He just gave me a wave, and I waved back. And Jesus looked at me and smiled, and I knew what He was saying. "He will be back. He's just visiting." I saw other people that had died and had gone to be with Jesus, other great preachers down through the ages. I saw them. They were out among the people, encouraging them, telling of the great wonders of heaven and the great things God has done for them. Some of them had been there a long time, but they were still learning. Just like little children, they were soaking up something they wanted to learn so bad. Then the angel on the left said, "We have to go toward the throne," and we were gone. Everything in heaven flows into the throne. However you get there, all traffic flows to the throne, from the veil, in the beautiful conveyances, coming down from the sky. However God brings you into heaven, all of heaven runs to the throne. People in heaven clamor to get to the throne and to talk to Jesus. They may be standing on the street corner, looking down the street, and Jesus might be walking down it. In wonderment, they exclaim, "He's coming. He's coming our way. We are going to get to talk to Him." I saw Jesus many times talking with people, and He would turn and look at me. I wanted to talk to Him, but I knew that I had to wait my turn. I felt great peace. Always when I saw Him, I had a desire to get before God on the throne.